This is Tomas Morales. He is a direct descendant of Quiche Indians, a branch of the great Maya people. He and his son are planting maize, corn, just as their forebears did hundreds of years before them. The clothes they wear are similar to those worn by generations of ancestors. Their tools, the same as have been used by the Indians who tilled this very soil centuries before. This is Juan Perez. His ancestors came from Spain. His job, managing a large banana plantation. This soccer game is being played on the campus of a modern university. Most of the players are Mestizos, or Ladinos, as they're called in this country, meaning they are of mixed Spanish and Indian ancestry. All are citizens of a nation called Guatemala. All, in one way or another, reflect the character, also the problems of an entire geographical area, an area called Central America. Central America is that narrow band of land which connects North and South America. A chain of mountains covers much of this strip of land, which includes lowlands covered by dense tropical rainforests, fertile plateaus, and unyielding uplands. An area as diverse and distinct as the people who inhabit it. Central America is composed of six independent republics: Guatemala, Honduras, Nicaragua, El Salvador, Costa Rica, and Panama. Today, like much of the rest of Central America, Guatemala is an area of violent contrast. Almost two-thirds of its population is of Indian descent, living primitively, barely getting sustenance from the soil. In a nation of many large, efficiently run plantations geared to produce maximum profit. Plantations such as this one, managed by Juan Perez, one of the 5% of Guatemalans of Spanish descent. Ramos, his foreman, is a Ladino, as is one-third of the nation's population. The Ladinos of mixed descent who work on the plantations, who live in the large cities and work in its stores. Most of the goods sold in these shops are imported, for Guatemala imports manufactured goods, machinery, chemicals, petroleum, iron and steel, even Hollywood films and U.S. cars. In fact, 70% of all imported goods come from the United States. The United States is also the main purchaser of Guatemala's exports, which are primarily coffee and bananas. Guatemala City, the nation's capital. Like the plantation system, it is increasingly modern, geared to today. Far different from the world inhabited by the great majority of Guatemala's population. Between the Morales family and Juan Perez and his Ladino foreman lies a gulf that has been only partly bridged in the more than 400 years since the Spaniards first conquered Central America, forming two worlds separated by economics, custom, and history. Two worlds, and each with its story to tell.
This is Chichicastenango. It is the village where I was born and where I now teach. There are two schools in the village, the public government school and this one, which is a church school. In this room are children of different ages, but by having each grade sit at a different colored table, we are able to avoid getting mixed up. Most of the time is spent learning how to read and write. This is Jose Morales. The past few weeks, his reading has become better. This is probably because he has been helped by Rosa, his sister, who is a very good student and a good reader. I have known the Morales family for many years. In fact, Tomas Morales and I once sat at the same table in the church school. Tomas is considered a wealthy man in Chichicastenango. He has a good house. And during the planting season, he and Jose can go out to his large field that is behind the house. For during planting time, the school is closed. In the same way that Tomas Morales learned from his father how to plant the corn, so he too has taught his own son. For Rosa, there are also things that must be learned. She must help her mother care for the baby child. Woman's work is getting the corn ready for planting. For such work, even little Luisa can be of help. The washing of clothes is also work the women must do. Because there is no water in the houses, the women must go down to the village fountain. In the water, they can not only wash clothes, but also their hair. Of all the work done by Indian women, this to Rosa seems the most difficult, also the most beautiful. Tablecloths and napkins made in villages such as ours are very much liked, even by the Ladinos who live in Guatemala City. This too, Rosa must learn, the making of tortillas. For tortillas are an important part of the diet of the people who live in Chichicastenango. In the evening, when the work has been finished, they kneel in the chapel, which Tomas Morales has made in his own house, and each one says his prayers. Rosa has brought the Good Virgin a gift. It is Sunday. On this day, all the roads that lead to Chichicastenango have the people moving quickly, for this is market day in our village. For this special day, Rosa will be able to wear her beads. Even the little one is to go. For the market is not only for buying and selling the potatoes, peppers, the little pigs. It is also a place to have a good time. For trying to get a good price, this can be very enjoyable. But because this is Sunday, it is also a day for the church. As we have our own way of living, we also have our way of praying.